We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2020. This is from 2019, and it's a one-shot celebrating IDW's 20-year anniversary. Now, the premise here is that 20 years has passed over the course of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles continuity, and we're looking at middle-aged turtles, or at least turtles in their 30s, and they are trying to fight off an invasion, well, a civil war, really, of the Utroms. Those are the Kranks people, and Donatello was trying to be a negotiator for the mutants and try and resolve the civil war. And things went poorly, of course, and now they're striking out to stop a terror dome, and it's basically the crux of the story. Everybody's a little more mature. Mikey's leading the group now. Leonardo has become more of a warrior monk. He's focused on his mystic arts, so he's a lot more aloof than the others. Raphael's calmed down a little bit, so it's an interesting story as a one-shot. It works, but the art's only okay, and it wasn't really a $5 story, but it's not terrible. It's a lot better than I expected. So the story was by Paul Allor, art by Nelson Daniel, letters by Shawn Lee, edits by Bobby Kernow, and of course published by Greg Goldstein. So I didn't hate it. I thought the art was a little bit of a mixed bag. There's some really good scenes in it, like the closer shots are fine, but some of the fighting scenes really need a little bit of anatomy work. There are some pretty good inside references. There's a great reference to Dr. Strangelove where they're sitting in the room with Big Board. I thought that was funny. Overall, was it worth $5? Probably not. Since it is kind of a forgettable one-shot, I don't think it was worth $5, but it was a neat idea. It was a cute story. I didn't hate it, but I kind of regret paying the cover price for it because it was an impulse buy, so I didn't really even get a discount on it, which kind of stunk. It was an interesting story for like dollar bin material. If you're looking for something that has a complete story, then this was good, but didn't really do it for me. I thought it actually would have been a much more interesting mini-series. So maybe when they do their 25th anniversary, they could do it as a four-parter. And I thought that would have actually expanded the story a little more and given a little more room for depth. If I was looking for a comic book to grab off the rack and just kill a few minutes with, this would be a good one for that, but I think it's more dollar bin material than anything else. So if you're paying more than, I'd say, $250 for it, you're probably going to feel pretty ripped off. $5, not really the price point for this one. But that's just my take. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. And we hope to see you on the next one.